Well, I think they have a very good team. I think everything that they've so far been able to accomplish, they've earned, and they've done it the hard way. When we took over at Purdue, we were in last place too. And so I understand that climb. And now, last year they get in fifth place and then get to the Sweet 16, what was a huge jump from where they were the year before. And they were making strides before. They just needed that next, in my opinion, that impact guy. I think they have that in Cody Zeller, which I consider the best player in college basketball. And so I think that's the difference. I think his unselfishness, how hard he works, Jordan Poles' work ethic. When you have guys of that nature, Aladipo, Sheehy, when you have blue-collar people with talent, that really gets contagious. And I think they have a chance this year to obviously, contend for a Big Ten championship. And anybody who, in my opinion, can contend for a Big Ten championship is good enough then to get to a Final Four and put themselves in position for a national championship.
Front right.
Hey, Coach. Going on that, you're in a lot of the same living rooms and open gyms as Indiana. What is Purdue's message amidst all this hype? What do you say to sell Purdue?
Well, I think you start with your education. You really don't worry about other people. Our education is top flight. I think we have great people at Purdue. And last time I checked, this is a people business. So I could, if you want to go in there and talk about rankings and talk about different things, we talk about trying to make it work two ways for a student athlete. You make it work for education, you make it work for basketball. And we've graduated every single one of our players in 7 years. I think our guys have gotten better. We haven't signed any NBA players, but yet we've put some people in the NBA. Anybody can sign an NBA player. Or can you take a guy that no one else in your league wants, and 4 years later he gets drafted in the first or second round? I think you're doing something that, as a staff, when you can say that. But probably the number one thing that I've heard from Coach Katie, is just always be straightforward and tell the truth. Your players might not like what you say, but at the end of the day, they'll respect you. You hit them between the eyes.